Christ is the mediator of a new covenant, so that by means of his death, those who are called may receive the promise of an eternal inheritance. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
So I welcome you to Mass this evening, Thursday in the fifth week of Lent in Passiontide. And this Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of Ferdinand Garcia Rangel. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. A special welcome to all parishioners, but especially to members of the parish choir, who are going to have a rehearsal for the Triduum after Mass, which is really rapidly approaching. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were lifted up to draw all people to yourself. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You shouldered the cross to bear our suffering and sinfulness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You opened for your people the way from death into life. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Be near, O Lord, to those who plead before you, and look kindly on those who face their Jesus said to the Jews, I tell you most solemnly, whoever keeps my word will never see death. The Jews said, now we know for certain that you are possessed. Abraham is dead and the prophets are dead, and yet you say, whoever keeps my word will never know the taste of death. Are you greater than our father Abraham, who is dead? The prophets are dead too. Who are you claiming to be? Jesus answered, if I were to seek my own glory, that would be no glory at all. My glory is conferred by the Father, by the one of whom you say, he is our God, although you do not know him. But I know him, and if I were to say, I do not know him, I should be a liar, as you are liars yourselves. But I do know him, and I faithfully keep his word. Your father Abraham rejoiced to think that he would see my day. He saw it and was glad. The Jews then said, you are not 50 yet, and you have seen Abraham. Jesus replied, I tell you most solemnly, before Abraham ever was, I am. At this they picked up stones to throw at him, but Jesus hid himself and left the temple. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Abraham is the first person in biblical history to have his name changed. In doing so, God is conferring on him a new personality and a new mission. He becomes a father of a multitude of nations, a father of the covenant. When our confirmandi, so that's the 9 adults at Easter, and the 5 teenagers later in June, when they choose a new name, I hope that the saint's name that they choose inspires them on their journey to holiness and their share in the mission to announce the gospel of the Lord, thus continuing the fulfillment and promise to Abraham of a multitude of descendants. The new and eternal covenant which we renew in the sacred tridium is our assurance that we will not see death, or at least the effect of it as understood by the world. The sanctifying grace of baptism means that death is not an annihilation of us or our relationships. Our goodness goes with us and our soul lives on. Serious sin, however, does lead to the death of the soul, so we should always seek to avoid sin and the near occasions of it. Blinded by their hostility to Jesus and the life of grace, many people, unfortunately, do not want to listen to God's word, and they fail to understand him and his holy church. Knowledge of Jesus and his teachings is vital. As he himself tells us, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. And he will say to Philip, who asked to see the Father, have I been with you all this time? To see me is to see the Father. So uniting ourselves to the life of Christ is an enormous advantage. For in doing so, we find it much easier to unite our will to God. Abraham rejoiced at the thought of seeing the day of Christ, and yet we see it every time we come to Mass, although we only experience it as a temporary measure in this world. But in the resurrection of Christ, we know it is a reality and will only be a matter of time before we experience it forever. Blessed are you, Lord, wonderful creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, created the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty, since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice and spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask your mighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of the holy angel to your portal and high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, Lord, who sleep in Christ, the place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who go sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Martha, Linus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, for whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. From heaven with heaven and heaven, O Lord, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of
on your side, queen of all is ever harmony, miserable of this. On your side, queen of all is ever harmony, miserable of this.
God did not spare his own Son, but handed him over for all of us. With him he has given us all things.
Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Firstly, many thanks to the 17 people who came and gave St. Mary Magdalene a good spring clean today. Understand that on Tuesday at 2 o'clock there's an opportunity to give Martha and Martha's a good spring cleaning for Easter, which I'm very grateful to. After this Mass, shortly after this Mass, I'll make myself available somewhere in the church for anyone who wants to make a Lenten confession. And the music group will be over there practicing for the sacred Paschal Triduum. So if you're a regular for Mass on a Thursday evening, don't forget that next week is beginning of the sacred Paschal Triduum, because next week is Maundy Thursday, so there's no 6:30 Mass. Mass will be the evening Mass of the Lord's Supper, and it begins at 8 p.m. here in St. Mary Magdalene. So it 8 p.m. for the start of the sacred Paschal Triduum. The Lord be with you.
And
bow down for the blessing. Be gracious to your people, Lord, we pray, that as from day to day they reject what does not please you, they may be filled instead with delight in your commands, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.